Dear students, welcome to the science class. In the last class, we were discussing about the gravitation topic. In that topic, we were discussing about the universal law of gravitation as well as acceleration due to gravity and free fall. So in that, we discussed about the equations of the uniform motion or accelerated motion. That is nothing but s equal to ut plus half at square, u equal to v equal to u plus ata, and v square equal to u square plus 2as. So those equations we are considering in the acceleration due to gravity topic also. So instead of acceleration, we are taking what? We are taking acceleration due to gravity. That is nothing but g. Based on those things, we are solving some numerical questions. In the yesterday class, we solved one question. In today's class, we are going to solve another example which is given in that topic. So let us consider example 10.3. An object is thrown vertically upwards and rises to a height of 10 meter. Calculate the velocity with object was thrown upwards. Second, time taken by the object to reach the highest point. Time taken by the object to reach the highest point. See here, if this is the ground, from the ground, a object is thrown in the vertical direction. So let this be the object here. Right? After throwing the object, object is reaching this much height. So that height is given. See here, an object is thrown vertically upward and rises to a height of 10 meters. So this height is 10 meters. When it is thrown from this point with an initial velocity of u. So what happens after reaching the height 10 meters? This object is going to stop again. It is going to fall down on the ground. So when it reaches this point, the final velocity of this object will be how much? Up to this point, it will going to travel with an uniform speed. After they are traveling this much height, it is going to stop there for some time. Then again, it is going to fall down towards the ground. So if it is stopping here, that means the final velocity of the object after reaching this height, that is nothing but after reaching 10 meters, the final velocity will be how much? It is equal to 0. So what we have to calculate by using this data? We have to calculate the velocity with the object was thrown upwards. So which one is that velocity? It is the initial velocity of the object which is thrown in the upward direction. So in this case, we have to find out the u by using this data. In the same manner, what we have to find out here, we have to find out the time taken by the object to reach the highest height. So we have to calculate the time taken by this object to reach the 10 meters height. So whatever the time is taking from this point, we have to calculate here. So this is about the problem. So first, what you have to do here, you have to write down the given data. So given, what they are given here, they are given the maximum height, that is nothing but distance covered. Already I told you that when an object is freely falling, or if you take that object in an atmosphere or sky, that object's height is nothing but it is the distance covered by the object. So height is nothing but what? It is the distance covered. So distance covered by the object. That is nothing but maximum height of the object. So what is that value? That is given as 10 meters. So it is equal to how much? It is equal to 10 meters. So it is s equal to 10 meters. Right, what they are again given? An object is thrown vertically in the upward direction and rises to a height of 10 meters. This only they are given. By that value, we have to calculate u as well as v. So final velocity of the object is also given. So the final velocity of the object is 0. Final velocity of the object, which is equal to how much? Which is equal to v equal to 0. So after reaching this height, we have to calculate what? Initial velocity we have to calculate. So we have another value, that is nothing but a constant value which is acting on this object, that is nothing but the gravitational force. So gravitational force will be acting in the opposite direction, and The acceleration of the gravitational force is nothing but acceleration due to gravity, which is a constant, which is given as 9.81 meter per second. So we can take their value. So that acceleration due to gravity, what is that value? It is g is equal to 9.81 meter per second square. So if you see here, object is moving in the upward direction and gravitational force is acting in the downward direction. For that reason, we should take the acceleration due to gravity value as minus. So it will be negative 9.81 meter per second square. So what we have to find out here? First, we have to find out the initial velocity. That is nothing but what? Which is u equal to question mark, and we have to calculate the time taken. Time taken to reach the highest height. So which is t is equal to question mark. Now see here. Whatever they given in the problem statement, they are given the total distance over s. They given the initial velocity, final velocity v is equal to 0. We have to find out the initial velocity, as well as they are given the g value. So we have two formulas for that. We have three formulas total. That nothing but one is s equal to ut plus half gt square. Second, 2as equal to v square minus u square. Third one is u equal to, or v equal to, u plus gt. So here we can take g. So if you see the given data, we can use this formula for the calculating of the initial velocity, that is nothing but u square. So by the formula, that is nothing but v square equal to u square plus 2gs. Therefore, v square is equal to how much? It is 0 square equal to u square plus, in the bracket, into 9.81 into what is the value of s here, which is equal to 10. So it will become what? U square plus 2 in the bracket minus 9.81 into 10 is equal to how much? It will be equal to 98, here equal to 98, so minus 98. Therefore, u square equal to plus into minus, it will be minus 2 into minus 98, it will be equal to how much? It will be equal to 196. Therefore, u square equal to, if you take minus into the LHS side, it will become plus. Therefore, it will be equal to 196. Therefore, u equal to how much? It will be equal to 14. And you can take u equal to square root of 196, which is equal to 14 meter per second. Therefore, u is equal to how much? It is equal to 14 meter per second. The initial velocity of that object which is thrown in the upward, vertical upward direction, which have a velocity of 14 meter per second. Next, what you have to find out here? We have to find out the time taken to reach the highest height. Again, we have three formulas here. One is s equal to ut plus half gt square. Two, here there is no time value parameter, so that we can't use this equation. We have v equal to u plus gt. If you see here in the problem statement, v is given, u we have find out here, g we know the value of g here, t we have to find out. So we are going to use this formula for the finding the time taken. So therefore, v equal to u plus gt. So what is v? 0 equal to what is the value of u? It is equal to 14 plus what is the value of g? 9 minus 9.81 into t. So if we take this value to the LHS side, it will become minus. So 9.81 t equal to minus 14, right? So therefore, minus minus get cancelled, t equal to 14 divided by 9.81. When you calculate it, it is going to give t equal to 1.4 seconds. T equal to 1.4 seconds. 1.45 seconds. So the time taken to reach the maximum height is equal to how much? It is equal to 1.45 seconds. Right. So this is the answer for the example 10.3. At last, write the conclusions here. The initial velocity of the object is which is equal to 40 meters per second, and the time taken to reach the maximum height is equal to how much? It is equal to 1.45 seconds. Depends on that value. If you consider this as 9.81, this value is going to change. If you consider this as 9.8, this value is going to change. So here it is 1.45 seconds. So this is about the example 10.3. So next we are going to discuss about the air resistance. So what do you mean by air resistance? Take an example that an object is falling from the atmosphere or in the sky. So what will happen if we take an example, activity is nothing but we are throwing a stone as well as a piece of paper from the third floor. It is falling on the ground, but the piece of paper taking more time compared to the stone. So why it is happening? It is happening because of the air resistance. So what is the air resistance? If you study about the frictional force in the 8th class, right? What is the frictional force there? Frictional force is nothing but it is the force which is opposing the state of motion, or which is opposing the movement of an object which is present in the contact with that surface. Right? In the same manner, air resistance is also a frictional force. That frictional force is exerted by the air molecules. That friction force which is exerted by the air molecule on the objects which are freely falling on the ground. So whatever the objects which are present in the space or which are present in the atmosphere, they are going to suffer a resistivity force. So that resistivity force is nothing but what? It is the air resistance. Like frictional force, the frictional force from the fluids are nothing but, or the frictional force from the air is nothing but what? It is the air resistance. So on which factor air resistance depends? So first factor, if you take the example of the stone as well as if you take the example of the piece of paper. Stone has the maximum mass, whereas piece of the paper has minimum mass. So air resistance depends on the mass of an object. More the mass, less the air resistance. Less the mass, more the air resistance. So that is the first factor which is affecting the air resistance. And the second factor, if you check the shape of the aeroplane, right? Why that aeroplane is made like this? So then it is going to suffer less amount of air resistance, less amount of air resistance. And they are decreasing the surface area of that aeroplane. So the air resistance is also depend on the surface area of objects. If you compare a stone as well as the piece of paper is lightweight or light mass. It has light mass, as well as the shape of the or the surface area of the piece of paper is higher. So if the higher surface area, more amount of air is going to resist it, or more amount of air molecules are going to resist the falling of that piece of paper. For that reason, piece of paper taking more time. So on that factor, air resistance depends. So first one is the mass of the object on which it depends. So that is more the mass, less the air resistance. In the same manner, it depends on the surface area of the object. Right, more the surface area, more the air resistance. So if you take a piece of paper or cloth, they are going to take more time since they are exerting or they are experiencing more amount of air resistance from the air molecules. Right, for that reason, they depend on the mass as well as surface area. So this is about the air resistance. Next, we are going to discuss about the mass and weight. Next, we are going to discuss about the mass and weight. So, what is the mass and what is weight? What is the difference between the mass and weight? Both are same thing only, mass and weight. So, mass is going to give the quantity of that object. Weight is also going to give the quantity of that object. So, what is the difference? Why we are taking differently the mass and weight? So, if you remember the previous class, that nothing but 9th class, 9th chapter, motion, where we studied, last chapter, that nothing but Newton's laws of the motion, where we studied about the Newton's first law, where we studied about the mass and inertia. Mass and inertia. So, what is the inertia? Inertia is the property. In the same manner, mass is also a property. Mass is also a property. More the mass, more the inertia. Right? Like that thing, mass is a property of an object. It is a property of an object which is measured in the kgs. And mass of an object is doesn't going to change. It not going to change anywhere. If you keep that object anywhere, if you keep that object on the moon, if you keep that object on the other planets, if you keep that object on the earth, the mass of the object is not going to change. So it is non-changing property of an object. So mass is a scalar quantity and it is not going to change. No change will be there in the mass. No change there will be in mass. Since it is a scalar quantity and its SI unit, you already know that it is SI unit is kg. And what is the mass here? It is the property of your object. Property of the object. Or we can say that it is the total quantity of an object. Or we can say it as the quantity of an object. Quantity of an object. Now then, what is the weight? What is the weight? So mass is not going to change anywhere. Then what is the weight? So if you take here weight, if I take an example here an object that is nothing but a person is standing here, right? So his mass is M. So what is the weight here? The weight of this object is nothing but it is the gravitational force which is acting on this person. So what is the gravitational force here? We already know that gravitational force is F equal to M into G. So if you instead of F, we are going to take the W is equal to M into G. So W equal to M into G is nothing but what? It is the weight of that person. So weight is nothing but what? It is the gravitational force which is exerted on that person. So that is W equal to what? M into G. And its SI unit, base SI unit is what? It is the same as the force. That is nothing but Newton. It is Newton. And weight of an object is differs. It is going to vary from place to place. If you check here, we already discussed about the acceleration due to gravity is going to vary from place to place. It will be different from different at the equator as well as it will be different at the pole region. So at the pole region, gravitation acceleration due to gravity will be more. At the equator region, acceleration due to gravity will be less. If there is a variation in the acceleration due to gravity at the pole as well as at the equator, in the same manner, weight of an object is also going to vary. It will be different at the pole region as well as it will be different at the equator region. It will be different at the moon and it will be different at the earth. It will be different at the different planets. So, weight of an object is directly depending on the acceleration due to gravity. So, it is indirectly depending on the gravitational force. If the more the gravitational force is there, then the more amount of acceleration due to gravity will be there. Then there will be more amount of weight is going to be there. So, in general, we can define weight as product of the mass into gravitational force or product of the mass into acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity. So this is the weight. I hope here the clear concept, the concept is clear about what is mass and what is the weight. So mass is nothing but it is the mass, quantity of that person or of that object. So if you take that object to the moon, its mass is not going to change. If you take that object to the other planet like Mars or Jupiter, the mass will be remain same. But weight of that object is going to change. Weight of that object is going to change since the gravitational force is also going to change. And the SI unit of the weight, which is unit as W, is Newton. SI unit of the weight is what? It is Newton. The weight is Newton. I is it is an vector quantity. Weight it is an vector quantity. Which is a vector quantity. Why it is a vector quantity? Since it has magnitude as well as direction. G comes acceleration due to gravity is a vector quantity. For that reason, this vector that is nothing but weight of an object is also a vector quantity. It has both magnitude as well as direction. Both magnitude as well as direction. Therefore, W is equal to M into G. So, this is about weight and mass. Weight and mass. So, let us consider an example of this thing. Right? An object having a mass of 10 kg. An object has the mass of 10 kg. So what will be the weight of that object on Earth? What will be the weight of that object on the Earth if the mass of that object is 10 kg? So we check here, we already know that what is W here, it is M into G. So W equal to M, that is 10. What is the G value? We already know that it is 9.8. So it is equal to how much? W equal to 98 kg meter second square, which is nothing but what? It is the Newton. 98 newtons. So W equal to how much? It is equal to 98 newtons. A object having 10 kg mass is going to have the weight of 98 newtons in on Earth. On Earth. So this is the major difference between mass and weight. If there is no gravitational force is there, zero gravitational force is there, then mass and weight will be equal. But that is not possible since every object has its own gravitational force. We already know about the universal law of gravitation. So this is about the mass and weight.